Hello and welcome to Akshu's Kitchen. Today we'll see how to prepare Bisi Bella Bath, for which we will need the following ingredients to serve approximately 3 to 4 people. 1 cup of rice, 1/2 cup of tur dal, 15 to 20 small onions or shallot onions, 1 lime sized tamarind, 1/2 tablespoon of grated coconut, 1 1/4 teaspoon of salt, 1/2 teaspoon of asafoetida, that is hing, 2 teaspoons of whole coriander seeds, 1 tablespoon of chana dal, 1/2 teaspoon of urad dal, 1/4 teaspoon of fenugreek seeds, 2 whole cloves, 1 inch size cinnamon, 1 teaspoon of poppy seeds, and 7 to 10 whole red chilies, dry red chilies, according to the required spice level and also according to the size of the chilies you are using. First, I have washed the rice and tur dal together, and to this I am going to add about 6 cups of water. I am adding boiling water directly from the kettle. I am using a pressure cooker to cook the rice and dal mixture. I am going to close it with the lid and pressure cook for about 4 to 5 whistles or according to your cooker. I am going to cook the rice more than usual, a little bit soft as we cook for the pongal. You can see the water is all absorbed and it is very soft and there is no layer in the bottom. It's in the perfect stage. So keep this aside ready. Next to the tamarind, I'm going to add about 1/2 cup of water and allow it to soak for about 10 to 15 minutes. And then I'm going to squeeze it well and prepare tamarind pulp or juice out of this and keep that also aside ready. Next in a pan, I'm going to add about 1/2 teaspoon of oil, and when it is hot I am going to add the whole coriander seeds first, the 2 teaspoon of coriander seeds, and I am going to add the other ingredients one by one, the chana dal, the urad dal and the fenugreek seeds along with the 2 cloves and 1 piece of cinnamon, and I am going to fry this in medium flame for about 2 to 3 minutes until it is light golden in color, and then I am going to add the whole red chilies to this, that's the dry red chilies, and continue to saute it for another 2 to 3 minutes, making sure you do not burn the ingredients. So once it's all done, I'm going to add the poppy seeds at the final stage. Give it a good mix for about 5 to 10 seconds, and then I'm going to add the 1 1/2 tablespoon of grated coconut. Poppy seeds will get burned easily if you add it along with the other ingredients, so that's the reason I've added the other ingredients first, sauteed until they are golden. Add the poppy seeds and finally add the coconut and again saute it for about 2 to 3 minutes until the coconut gets light golden color and shrinks well. Now you can see the coconut is all merged with the other ingredients. Allow this to cool down in a separate plate or dish, and once it's cooled down, I'm going to transfer it to a mixer or blender and I'm going to grind it into a fine powder and keep that also aside ready. You can see it's ready now. So all the ingredients are ready now. Next we are going to combine all of them. So in the same pan I am going to add another 1 1/2 tablespoon of oil and add the 15 to 20 small onions or shallot onions, and I am going to fry them really well in medium flame until it turns golden in color. So the rice is cooked, the masala is cooked, so everything is cooked. The only thing remaining uncooked is the onions. So to match with the other cooked ingredients, you have to cook it really well in medium flame until it is golden in color like this, and then add the prepared tamarind juice, that's the 1/2 cup of tamarind juice, and allow it to come to a boil and let it simmer in medium flame for about 1/2 minute. I'm going to add the salt and the asafoetida or hing to this and let it boil for about 1/2 minute so that the raw smell of the tamarind is all gone, and then I'm going to add the prepared masala mixture. Once you add the masala, it will become very thick, so make sure you do not add a very thick tamarind pulp, then you'll find it very difficult to combine it with the rice. Make sure you have a correct consistency of the tamarind pulp, not too thick nor too dilute. If it is too dilute, then the rice will become very watery. So after it has boiled for about 1/2 minute, I have added the masala mixture and give it a good mix. You can see it has thickened very well. Now I am going to transfer the rice cooker to the burner and I am going to add the prepared masala to the already ready rice and mix it all together so that the masala gets combined with the rice and tur dal mixture really well. Since we have cooked the rice really soft, it is very easy to combine it all together. And now bisibella bath is almost ready. Finally, I'm going to add about 1 teaspoon of ghee to this. It's optional, you can skip it if you don't want, but it gives a unique flavor and taste to the bisibella bath. Again, mix it well so that the ghee spreads evenly all over, and you can serve it hot. It is ready. Today I have not added any vegetables but only the small onions. If you wish, you can boil some potatoes or carrots or any vegetable of your choice, and you can add it along with the small onions. Also, if you don't want the rice to be too soft and you want it in the normal texture, you can reduce the amount of water and cook for about just 2 or 3 whistles, and you can also serve it in the normal texture. Try it and you'll really like it. Thank you for watching Akshu's Kitchen.